The Philippines receives nearly a million more doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine. The jabs were donated by the U.S. government through the vaccine sharing facility COVAX. Another batch containing 924,000 Pfizer shots will be arriving later today. The Philippines expects to reach more than 100 million vaccine deliveries by the end of the month. All in all, over 22 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. That makes up almost 30% of the country's target by the end of the year.
The Philippines logged 12,159 new COVID infections on Sunday. That's the highest number recorded in a week as the health department encountered problems with the COVID's data system. But active cases have dropped to 90,927, the lowest in nearly 2 months, after more than 27,000 patients recovered from the disease. The 15.9% positivity rate is also the lowest since July 31st. The Octo Research Group says Metro Manila might be classified as low risk for COVID-19 by the end of October, as the seven-day case average falls from 6,000 to 2,000. Meanwhile, several areas in northern Luzon like Baguio City continue to see a rise in infections.
Papansin din natin, medyo lumalakas naman yung virus pag medyo malamig yung climate o yung weather. Mm-hmm. At siguro kaya rin every ganito, bare months, nagkakaroon na naman ang pagtaas ng cases sa ibang bansa na malalamig.
The Philippine Tourism Department eyes further reduction of COVID-19 testing fees for domestic tourists. Tourism Secretary Bernadette Romulo Puyat says currently tourists can avail of a 750 peso or 50% discount in their RT-PCR tests at the Philippine Children's Medical Center. But she believes the discounted fee is still expensive. The DOT is now looking at further reducing testing costs by establishing satellite offices for discounted testing for tourists. It's also subsidizing the price of RT-PCR tests for tourists at the Philippine General Hospital, making it more affordable at 950 pesos.